We are getting set for the light heavyweight contest between Yamaguchi Falcao of Brazil and Marcus Browne of the United States of America. The other guys in their category, Osmar Bravo and Carlos Gongora, those are the four qualified boxers. There were 17 that came into this tournament at 81 kilograms with only four medals, or rather four tickets to go to London. And these are the four men, as Falcao beat Francisco Ortega from Mexico, Jonathan Savard from Canada, and Osmar Bravo from Nicaragua, all on points to get here tonight. You could hear the crowd is getting loud for another one of their hometown heroes. But not to be outdone, the American Marcus Browne, the Shaolin monk from Staten Island, Trinidad, the Declan Calist Valera, were some of the guys he's beaten to get here. And now he makes his way to the ring to vie for the gold medal. Referee Anna Martinez from República Dominicana, she will be the third person in the ring, keeping a close eye on the action. Falcao Yamaguchi, 24 years old. The judges, Riebe, McFarlane, Abdelharim, Del Puerto, and Beckles. As Falcao, a World Series of Boxing participant, he took the first place medal at the 2010 Brazilian National Championships. He boxed in Baku, Azerbaijan last year at the AIBA World Championships. He grabbed the silver at the Pan American Games in Guadalajara last year. Marcus Browne, he is the 2012 national champion for the United States. He also was in Azerbaijan, Baku, took first in last year's USA National Olympic Trials. So lots of experience to go around. Browne in the blue corner, Falcao in the red corner. Browne boxing in the southpaw stance, lets his hands go early. And Falcao standing in there looking for an opportunity. Both of these guys boxing in the southpaw stance. We've seen it many times before. A kindled enthusiasm for these two youngsters going for gold. They've already got their tickets to London written. This is about something else. When they meet in London, each one wants the measure of the other man, and this is how he's going to get it. The crowd chanting Yamaguchi, throws a double right hand, a straight right, followed by a hook, and that one was nice. Browne ties him up in the center of the ring. Looks like it could already be the makings of a rough contest. Fundamental principles are key to boxing. Things like using your jab, working behind your jab, keeping your hands up high, protecting yourself at all times. Good footwork, good head movement. Nice, fast left hand by Browne, scores, and Browne follows up with another one. Marcus Browne has long arms, and he shoots a big right hand over the top that seemed to stun Falcao. And Browne really opening up here in round number one. A compelling force indeed is Marcus Browne. And Falcao with an astonishing facility to take some of those punches continues to press the action. Some real acrimonious warfare here in round one as both boxers are letting their hands go. Browne stabs a right hand jab, doubles it up, triples it up. Nice work. Doesn't have to score as long as Falcao knows that jab is coming. He needs to be weary of it. And now Falcao presses Browne into the corner. Browne spins him around. Browne looking to get things going again with that jab. He had great results with it at the beginning of this round. There's a nice chopping right hand by Brown, and that one scores and issues a standing eight count. The crowd does not like it. Falcao does not believe it was warranted, but the referee felt so. So Brown gets a standing eight count and another chopping right hand. Good work by Brown here in round number one. Falco's got his work cut out for him here in the waning moments of this stanza. A stabbing right hand by Falcao. And that's it. Round one is in the books. And the American Marcus Brown jumps out to an early 6-3 lead. Convincing forcefulness by Marcus Brown to get things going. Take a look at some of the action here. There's a chopping left hand, laser left hand by Brown that just caught Falcao off guard. He did not see it coming. The ones that hurt the most are the ones you don't see. You can trust me on that. Here's a right hand by Brown, and a left hand as they're in the clinch. He's trying to get out. There's that jab. Both boxers jab at the same time, and both jabs land at the same time. There's a certain inner restlessness in Marcus Brown. Left hand by Falcao, and Brown ties him up. The referee issues a caution to Brown, or rather to Falcao. It looks like both of the boxers were cautioned as Brown is sent to his corner to have his chin strap adjusted. Right hand lead by Falcao to start things off. Certain jaunty confidence by Falcao as he continues to press forward. Brown throws a left hand. It's blocked by the high guard of Falcao. Falcao comes forward with a right and a left hand. He's now got Brown up against the ropes. Brown fighting his way off. Digging right hooks to the body is Falcao, and Brown not too happy. We've had a couple of pauses here in the second round that have prevented the rhythm from picking up the way it was in round one. Let's see if these two boxers can pick up that staccato dance that they had going in round number one. This gladiatorial exercise between these two light heavyweights here in Rio de Janeiro. Things getting feisty in the corner as Falcao has Brown up against the corner. The crowd's getting loud. Brown escapes harm with a gymnastic agility to get out of there. But he also finds himself back up against the rope, circling to his right. Good slip of the punch by Brown. He ties up Falcao again, and now he pushes a forearm into Falco's face, and the referee issues a caution to Falcao for holding the arm of Brown. A left hand by Falcao misses. So these two boxers, where they were trading punches in the first round, now look to be trying to keep their distance. Falcao really chasing Brown down, while Brown doing a good job of luring him in. Be nice to see Brown start to pick him off with some counter punches, while Falcao tries to close the distance between the two of them. Every time Falcao tries to cut off the ring, Brown is out of there, slipping out the back door, and see you later. Here comes Falcao with another wild left, and he misses. Left hand to the body, rather to the shoulder by Falcao. He's got a bloodthirsty malice, does Falcao. Unfortunately, he has not yet been able to really land any meaningful punches here in round two. Nice left hand by Browne. Counter right by Falcao seemed to fall short, but I think the American is starting to pull away. That's a 3-0 round in round number two, making the lead 9-3 for the American Marcus Browne. Take a look at some of this action. They locked horns quite a bit here in the second round on a calamitous course, but it was Browne that got the better of those exchanges. You saw some chopping right hands by Falcao as he's just trying to get whatever he can out of this contest by way of scoring blows. We are just set for the third and final round here in this light heavyweight contest. Marcus Browne of the United States in the blue corner. Yamaguchi Falcao from Brazil in the red corner. He's got his work cut out for him now. He finds Browne in the corner. Browne escapes. The crowd gets loud. Falcao on the attack. Browne slips a right hand in there. Right hand by Falcao. The problem is Falcao cannot seem to find Browne. Browne doing a good job of circling away. Falcao would be well served to use better foot movement, shorter, faster steps instead of the big, long steps that allow Browne to see them coming. He's telegraphing his movements with his big, long strides. He should use smaller, swifter steps to try and cut off the ring and force Browne to fight him. Browne has no need to fight him. He's already going to London. He's already earned that spot. He's up on the scorecards here through two rounds. He could skate through this third round and do what he's doing, using good lateral movement to stay away and avoid the charging Falcao and come away with the gold. Falcao must know that by now. With just over a minute and 40 seconds to go in this round, he can't let Browne continue to do this. He needs to cut off the ring. He needs to make Browne fight him. Browne sticks out a double jab. Right hand by Falcao misses. Browne throws a 1-2 combination and they tie up again in the center of the ring. The referee issues a caution to Browne. The Brazilian seeming a little forlorn. A nice right hand by Browne. Looks like it stunned Falcao. Falcao said, come on, let's do it. But every time he does, there's a left hand by Falcao. Looks like it may have grazed the head of Browne. And now Falcao finds Browne up against the corner. Excuse me, up against the ropes. And Browne walks right over him. An act of defiance as Falcao gets up and wipes his gloves off. The referee issues a caution to Browne. I don't know if there's enough time for Yamaguchi Falcao to right this ship. Just over a minute to go. This will be a dazzling triumph for Marcus Browne if he can pull away this victory in the home stadium of Yamaguchi and pull out a gold. The second gold would be a consecutive one after his teammate Terrell Gausha took the middleweight gold in the last contest. And again, Browne just skating on the outside using lateral movement. Now the referee is going to issue a caution to Browne. She suspected that's what he was doing and she asked him to continue to box. Browne sticks a jab out there. The crowd's getting loud. Falcao tries to corner Browne up against the ropes. Browne, not an easy man to contain. Nice lunging right hand by Falcao, but it misses. And Falcao is just chasing Browne around the ring, an exercise in futility. And now with over 10 seconds, 14 to be precise, it's just a matter of moments before Marcus Browne will be holding his hand in victory, and Falcao is just resigned to the fact that there's nothing he could do. And there go up the hands of Browne as the crowd does not like it. They boo. Yamaguchi Falco comes over and congratulates Browne and his corner. A defeated man he seems, but he should not be. He certainly earned respect in this tournament. He's got himself a ticket to London already, does Yamaguchi Falco. Along with Osmar Bravo and Carlos Gongora from Nicaragua and Ecuador respectively, they are your four Olympians in the light heavyweight division. And there it is, Marcus Browne with a 5-3 victory in the third. He pulls out a 14-6 defeat over Yamaguchi Falco of Brazil. And that is it, the final score of the light heavyweight division. We're down to two more contests in this tournament. Remember that the Women's Championships is taking place this week in China. As far as the World Series of Boxing is concerned, the Milano team, the Milano Thunder, was crowned the WSB team champions, and the individual championships will be taking place in the very near future, all at the Elite XC XL in London. Carlos Gongora gets a bronze from Ecuador. here in this current medal ceremony, which is taking place. Osmar Bravo gets the other. These are the light heavyweights. Bravo, Falcao, Gongora, and Browne on the platform. The Yamaguchi Falcao, the local Brazilian favorite at light heavyweight, gets the silver. It is Deborah Meth, Chief of Staff of Secretary of Sports and Leisure, that has been handing out the flowers here and the medal being presented by Carlos Arthur Neusman, President of the Brazilian Olympic Committee, as Marcus Browne, the gold medalist, bows his head in a sign of respect and gets the medal placed around. Well earned indeed. There they are, folks. They are your light heavyweight medalists. They'll see each other again real soon in London, and we will see them too. Take a look, remember their faces.